So let's take a look at what's happening here. Right here is when the action camera is triggered and then it cuts onto another camera. So from the gameplay camera, it cuts to the action camera right here when it is triggered. And then after that, we have some movements here on the action camera, which is tracking the hand movements of Ezio. And then it blends back onto the gameplay camera smoothly. Let's break down what's happening on my own version. We have the trigger here. The trigger is when the takedown happens. And then it changes onto the action camera, tracking the movements of the player character here and where the action happens. And then after that, it blends back onto the gameplay camera slowly. So, like this. Now, how can we recreate that in Unreal Engine using Instant Sequence Manager? This is actually very similar to what I did for my game, Unplug the Game.
My brother, and I'll crush every single one of you that gets in my way.
And now, here's how I did it.
Since you've placed the Instant Sequence player onto the level and you've set this up to be an action cam, now we are going to create our own sequences. To do that, let's say for example we have an animation here, and this animation is paired with this. I already have this level sequence that is made exactly for that animation. I've got this guy set up and I've created my own camera. I've animated the camera so that it follows the action closely, as you can see here. And when the animation is done, I've set this camera cuts to can blend and just drag off the pin here, like the corner of the camera cuts. Start the blending from right around here, so it blends back onto the current camera position. The sequence manager that is available on Magnum Combat is already custom coded so that if the camera is, say, on the right side of the player character, then the right animation will play. So I have like different animations for each direction. So this one's for the left one, and this is for the right. And let me just show you one of the animations here. So for example, the camera is on the right side of the player character. It will look something like this. It blends onto the desired position. So from here, it blends onto the desired position, which is here. And then it blends back onto where the camera was from. So to create something like this, you just have to put on your own animation onto 000, make sure it's on 000, like this, 000000, everything's on 000, and then you animate the camera based on the movements of the animation that you've set up, and then you just set this guy to invisible for reference later. You might need to delete that, but but if it's not visible, it's not bothering anyone. Oh, and also make sure that the collision is set to no collision. Using Instant Sequence Manager, everything's already set up for you. It's already streamlined, and all you need to do is just set this up as the transform origin actor using override instance data. Make this variable true if you have Magnum Combat, and if you don't have Magnum Combat and you only have Instant Sequence Manager on your player character, call the director BP and call the Instant Sequence player. Yeah, let's see the results. So that's how you use Instant Sequence Manager, and that's how you set up your own takedown cams for Magnum Combat. Thank you so much for watching, and good luck with your own projects.